Hi guys, my name is Michelle and I create hair, makeup and lifestyle content here on YouTube. Today we're going to be talking about the Fix My Curls Curl Quenching Hair Butter. So if that sounds like something that interests you, then keep watching. I'm starting on damp hair and I'm using the Fix My Curls Curl Quenching Hair Butter. I've used 12 grams. This is what 12 grams of product looks like. So I'm using half for one side of my hair, emulsifying it with some water. Glazing and also using praying hands to apply the leave-in conditioner. Some roping action going on there as well. Whatever's left over on my palms will go to my roots as always. Using the remaining product for the other half of my hair. Diluting it with some water and emulsifying. Just glazing it through to apply. You will see that sometimes leave-in conditioner will pill up and bunch up on your hair, no matter how much you dilute them. Which is why I recommend combing through to distribute the product evenly. I also like applying the product when I'm standing upright. This helps me to ensure that all of my hair has gotten some product, and so in that way it helps with even distribution. Adding water in between to ensure that my hair remains wet throughout the styling process. Now I'm switching to an upside down position and combing my hair. At this step, I'm only focusing on directing the hair away from my scalp to make sure that nothing is sticking to my scalp. I've explained the reason behind this in depth in my upside down styling video, so check that out if you haven't already. At this point, I'm not focusing on creating curl clumps yet. Right now, it's all about getting the hair away from the scalp because this is something that's going to give me maximum volume. Shaking to avoid any clinging and clasping at the roots. From this point on, I'm going to start focusing on creating my curl clumps. Remember that hair clumps when it is wet enough. So if you want to avoid stringy clumps, spray your hair with copious amounts of water before creating your curl clumps. Now with the comb, I'm going to start creating my clumps. I'm going to start scrunching my hair to encourage my curls to form. If you have enough water in your hair, you're going to hear that squishing sound as you scrunch and pulse. Turn in all directions and scrunch. If you're not hearing the water while you scrunch, then please spray your hair down with more water. You want to hear that nice squishy sound. Take your time while scrunching, especially if you have wavy hair. Glaze every time you feel like you're getting frizz or flyaways. Keep scrunching till you're satisfied with the curls that you've formed. Now for some gel. Spread the gel on your palms and glaze the lengths of your hair gently. Don't pull apart your curl clumps. You want to make sure that you coat your lengths evenly. And then one last time, scrunch and pulse. At this point, you want your hair to feel slippery and slimy and gloopy like seaweed. Okay, I'm gonna plop. I'll be back when my hair is dry. Okay, so my hair is completely dry. I've scrunched out the crunch. This is what it looks like. You'll agree that this is a lot of volume. I upside down styled today because I wanted the results to be comparable to the Fix My Curls leave-in cream, which is why I used exactly the same technique to style. If you want to know more about how I upside down style my hair, then you can check that video out. I'll keep it up here. And if you missed my review on the Fix My Curls leave-in cream, then you'll find that review also up here. So, in that last video, I already explained the concept of the levels. So, level 1 to 6, and I also broke down who could use what level, what's gonna suit your hair, etc. So, if you haven't watched that video, I'll leave it up here. Check it out when you're done with this one. In that video, I spent 26 minutes explaining the levels to you guys. So, I'm not gonna put you through that again. All I have to say that this is a solid level 4. So, I have high porosity 2B to 2C hair, and this is absolutely heavy enough for my hair. But the great thing about heavier products is that even if your hair does not prefer, let's say, a level 4.5, you could absolutely manipulate this product and make it work for you by diluting it or just by using less of the product. The Fix My Curls Curl Quenching Hair Butter is a moisture product, and high porosity girls struggling with moisture retention will really like this product because firstly it has flaxseed, which is a film forming humectant, and also it has Tecuma Butter, and high porosity girls absolutely love Tecuma Butter. So, I have a video coming out on protein moisture balance, and before I speak about how to balance your hair with protein and moisture, I've also broken down the different ingredients. So, I've broken down moisture, I've broken down the sources of moisture, so what to look out for in your products in particular, what kind of butters your hair would like if you're high, low, medium porosity, what kind of oils your hair would like if you're high, low, medium porosity, what you need to do if you're a high porosity girl struggling with moisture retention, and I won't go into all of that just now. I would highly recommend you wait for a week, and those videos will slowly be releasing. Check them out. But yeah, I've already shot the videos, and what I mentioned in those videos are, if you're struggling with moisture retention, then a film forming humectant like flaxseed is really going to help you, and this product has that. Secondly, if you're a high porosity girl, then Tecuma Butter is the butter to go for. And this has Tecuma Butter, so great news for us high porosity girls. But if you're medium to low porosity and you're wondering, can I make this product work? Well, Amrupali will talk about her experiences with the product later on in the video. And that should sufficiently answer your question as to whether you can make this product work for you. Let me talk you through some of my experiences with the product, being a high porosity 2B2C girl. My hair did not have any problem retaining moisture right till day 3, day 4 with this product. And if you've been here on my channel, you know that that is something that I really, really struggle with. On day 1, my hair sometimes looks really nice and really glossy. And then by day 2 and day 3, I keep wondering where did all of that moisture go. But I did not have any of those problems using this product. Another benefit of the product is that if you've seen my pin curl refresh video, I'll leave that video up here. I would highly, highly, highly recommend you use it. So if you've seen my pin curl refresh video, what I did was I used this product and I used it with a gel. But the last time I was in Pune, I had a gig there. I posted about it on my Instagram stories. I did not have time. And so I used this just with some water and I pin curl refreshed. And oh my goodness, you guys know that I'm a gel girl through and through. My hair cannot get enough of it. But this product has some hold in itself. So if you're pin curl refreshing, then just a bit of water and this product is absolutely sufficient. The best part about eliminating that gel from your pin curl refresh routine, if you're using this product, is that your hair dries much, much, much faster. If you're with me on Instagram, you know that my last gig in Pune, I did not have time. I had 10 minutes. I pin curl refreshed with some water and this. 10 minutes, my hair was dry. I scrunched out the crunch because this product has some hold and I was ready. And guys, the next time I pin curl refresh, this is my go-to product. I'm not going to use anything else. This is absolutely sufficient. Now, since this product has some hold, let me talk to you about few other uses that you can put this product to. So on day 2 or day 3, if you feel like you absolutely must refresh your hair, and guys, I do not recommend you refresh your hair. Well, at least I don't do it. When I started CGM, I swore to myself that for 1 year, I'm going to be super, super, super good. And then when I feel like my hair is doing better, that is when I'll start experimenting with refreshes, etc. But right now I don't do it all that much. However, I wanted to check to see if this product would work well with a refresh. So all I did was I took some water, I took a tiny, tiny, tiny bit of this product and I mixed it in on my hands and then I just glazed my hair. I didn't do anything else. I did not detangle my hair and I noticed that it really did help me with the flyaways. And in that sense, I feel like this could also be your go-to refresh product if you're in a hurry and you just have 2 minutes to make your hair look semi-decent and step out the door. Now, since I've spoken so much about me being high porosity, I also want to tell you guys that this is not only a product for high porosity hair just because it's like a 4 to 4.5. If you just use less of it or if you dilute this product, you could be a 2B low porosity wavy girl as well and also make this product work for you. Because remember, if the product is, let's say, a level 2, you can't use more of it and make it heavier. But if the product is a level 4, you could absolutely dilute it or use less of it and manipulate the product in such a way that it works for you. So I've covered all of the things that I loved about this product. Now let's talk about the things that I did not like about this product. Number 1, fragrance. Oh my goodness. This has artificial fragrance, and if you are sensitive to fragrances and you get migraines, then when you're styling with this product, the fragrance isn't going to affect you so much. But when you're pin curl refreshing with this, and of course you'll be using a little extra product, right? That is when this could absolutely flare up your migraines. So please be very careful if you're sensitive to fragrances. However, when you're styling with this and this is diluted and you have all that water in your hair, it's not gonna bother you. But if you're pin curl refreshing, then please, please, please be careful, because this could be something that triggers your migraines. It absolutely does in my case. So please be very careful with this product if you're someone who's very sensitive to fragrances. You guys know that I'm very, 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 very sensitive to fragrances. Anything extra and my migraines flare up. And I definitely did feel like I was getting migraines when I used this to pin curl refresh. Fix My Curls, if you're watching this video, please do something about the fragrance in this product, because some of us will absolutely want to go to this product if we want to pin curl refresh. If we're short on time, in fact, this would be my only go-to when it comes to pin curl refreshing. It's like a one and done product. I can't get enough of it. It saves me when I don't have too much time and I need my hair to look good. So please do something about the fragrance. It definitely does trigger migraines in some people. Now, the second thing that I did not like about this product. Yes, the product is heavy. Yes, the product allows my hair to retain moisture, but frizz, frizz, frizz. All of January when I tried both the leave-in cream and the curl quenching hair butter from Fix My Curls, I realized that my hair was looking way more frizzy. Since I film every week, I know what my hair looks like on camera, and you'd have to agree that my hair definitely looks extremely frizzy. If you look at all of my videos from January, you'll notice that my hair looks extra frizzy. However, frizz means volume, and that's why I have so much volume today. But the frizz is something that I definitely could live without. So that is the second thing that I did not like about the product. So today while styling, I measured out how much of the product I used, and I used 12 grams. This is a 200 gram bottle, which means that this would last me 16 washes, which roughly translates to 4 months. So these are my thoughts on the product. Now let's listen to what Amrapali has to say. And in the last video, Amrapali told you a lot about her hair. So if you haven't watched that video, you should definitely check it out. And then everything that she says will make more sense to you. So in my last review, I asked Amrapali to share her thoughts on the product in question. And I did the same for this video because her hair is very different to mine. Let's listen to what she had to say.
Hi guys, so today I'm going to be talking about the Fix My Curls Blue bottle that we did talk about in the last review video as well. Talking a little bit, telling you a little bit about my hair. It is a low to medium porosity hair, and I've been doing CGM for the past 6.5 months now. In the previous video with Michelle, I did mention that I did not like the product that much because to me it was a little heavy in the moisture content, and it kind of made my hair not fall well or did not have the proper bounce or the hold. But I realized what I was doing wrong. I was actually pre-pooing the length of my hair, which obviously the oil does not wash out with a sulfate-free shampoo. So after that, when you use a moisture-heavy product, it does not give you the same kind of bounce or hold as you expect it to give. So now, considering that, after a few more washes without pre-pooing the length of my hair, I realized that the product is absolutely amazing, and I would definitely use it again. Talking about the amount that I used for my length of hair, I used about a coin size and a little bit more on completely wet hair in the shower after it was detangled. I also used the Denman upright styling technique, which I have been for the past 6 months now, and followed by the general styling method and the gel. So coming back to the product, I think it is definitely a very good product when it comes to a moisture product available to us in India. I would definitely want to use it again, and doing it right, not pre-pooing the length of my hair but just my scalp, and sticking to my usual routine. So one thing worth the mention would be that for me, on the third and the fourth day, I did see a lot of frizz that usually I do not get. Like for example, today is the fifth day, and you see that I have a lot of frizz coming out. But I guess they say that embrace your frizz. So far the product has been really good. I don't know about this frizz. I have observed that it is only in this product that it does, my hair kind of gets a little frizzy on the third day, but I am happy that I don't have to wash my hair on the third or the fourth day. So considering that, I would definitely want you guys to try it and see how your hair reacts, and give it some time. Don't judge a product by the first or the second wash like I did in my last video. So I take it back, and I would definitely want you guys to try it. So yeah, let Michelle know how you feel. and thanks a lot.
Yay! Amrapali, thank you so much for sharing your feedback, because I know people with the same porosity and curl type watching this video would benefit from your thoughts and your experiences with the product. Guys, if you've tried the curl quenching hair butter from Fix My Curls, then please leave your hair type, meaning your curl type, your porosity, your density, down in the comment section and let us know what you thought about the products and how it worked for you. That way, if somebody with the same porosity, density and curl type is reading the comments, they could also be enlightened by your experiences. Alright guys, that was it. If you gained value from the video, then leave me a thumbs up, leave me a comment, all of it really helps me get this video in front of more people. If you want, you can follow me on Instagram because I share a bit there as well. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. My name is Michelle and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.